Hello, everybody. This is Tamara with Tamara's Coloring Coven. Before going any further, I want to let you guys know that if you're 18 and under, I ask you kindly to please leave, as this is an adult and coloring crafting channel for YouTube. Thank you very much. Today, we are going to do something, and this is a book I got from Dollar General called Cute Foods by Bindon, and I got it for like $3. I wanted to do my own version of this and that questions, and the people I am going to tag in it, I will leave their links down below in the video, or not down below in the video, but I will leave their links to their YouTube channels in the underneath this video in the description. But the people I'm going to tag is Elena from Coloring with Elena, Amanda with Adult Coloring with Amanda Loves Art, My Coloring Corner with Renee, Michelle with Michelle Creates, My Colorful Country Life with Karen, Davissa with DJ's Colorful Escapes, Pamela with Pamela's Passion for Pencils, and Belinda with Colorful, or Color, excuse me, Belinda with Color with Faithful Girl 1978. And I will leave, like I said, I will leave their links to their YouTube channels down below and under this video. Make sure to go as well with me. Please hit that like video. Give us a thumbs up if you like us. Subscribe, click that little red button. And if you want to get further notifications from all of us, click that little bell for further notifications for future videos. Okay, now let me get my questions. I have them. Okay, yes, I do. Okay, the picture we're going to do today is this picture here. The reason I chose this is before I was able to do YouTube videos again, I had people ask me how I was able to do citrus fruit. Well, today I'm going to kind of show you what I did. Now, I did it all with gel pens. I'm going to show you what I did. The only thing with this one that I can't really show is the outer edge, or like the color of the dark colors of the rind and stuff. But I will tell you what I did. So I've had a lot of people, like I said, ask me how I did, and it's pretty self-explanatory if you have the right gel pens. If not, then just do whatever you want with your heart's content. So I'm going to get my questions, and these are my questions that I ask you guys. And let me see, will that look better with the light on? Yeah, sorry guys, yeah, that would look so much better with the light on. Actually, sorry guys about that flash out. I'm still learning this new camera. Okay, first of all, I'm going to show you how to do a lemon. Normally you need three colors, and I have a regular yellow, and how I got it, I don't know, and a gel pen. I save it sporadically. But you need normally a yellow, regular yellow for the outer rim, of course, to show what colorful color is a solid color for lemon. In the middle, you got on that line, you got kind of a paler color. So what I use is for the yellow, I use that neon yellow because I don't have any lighter yellow. For the part in the lime, or not lime, in the lemon that looks juicy, I use any type of color that it is, if that is glitter in it. That means like for an orange, you use one of those regular, I use a jelly roll pen in the regular original orange. For the middle, this is just a regular gel pen. That's a pastel one. It kind of comes out a lightish orange. For the middle, I've got a glitter gel pen, a jelly roll pen of the orange. And then, of course, for a line, I do, of course, a dark green, which I use the original jelly roll pen of the original green, dark green for the outer skin. This one for the middle rind. And of course, a green one with glitter in it to give it that. You want glitter in the middle, it'll give it that, not only that shine, but it'll make it look like it's wet, which is basically what fruit is wet. Okay, so I need to get first. I thought I had one. I guess I don't. Let me I need a couple of napkins in the can.
Okay. I thought I had a napkin over there, but I guess not. Thank you very much, hon. Okay. Now I'm going to use a napkin because I don't want to smudge it and stuff. But we're going to start with a yellow one. Here, whoops, yellow. And I'm going to ask my questions. Now some of these are doozy, some are easy, and some of them are doozy, even for me. That's why I had to ask them. My first question is, what are your favorite budget brand pencils, markers, or pens? Now, with my favorite budget brand pencils, and I know people are going to gasp at me with my crazy art. I said this the other day in a video of mine that I did. Sometimes these milky pens don't want to. Unless I can get it flowing, because that's a good thing. But sometimes they just don't want get going. Yeah, got it. My favorite budget brand markers, I would have to say it's a toss up between Sharpies and Bic. I know I'm not a big fan of Pen and Gear. I don't know if I just got a bad batch. When I got the, I think it was like a 21 set is what it was, or something like that, that came in a hard plastic case. The only thing good about that was the case, that it wasn't worth my 21 something dollars. This wasn't. So now I've got my gold gel pen. I'm going to do the inside. I'm making this one a lemon. But yeah, I wasn't impressed with the Pen and Gear. I don't know if I just got a bad set or not, but that's okay. I've got enough markers right now to kind of last me for a while. I would rather use up what I have. If anything, if I have to get any marker replacements, it's just going to be of the certain colors that I need. Like for when I do my tattoo coloring books that everybody knows I love, if I have a book that's where they're double-sided and it's of a person, I'll use a watercolor marker, especially when it comes to their skin, because I mostly do all my tattoo pictures in either marker, but mostly gel pens. The second question is, do you like using only one type of medium or mixed media? I, myself, I'm a mixed media person. I love using mixed media in my pictures. Next, what I'm going to do is the green one, even though it's not the shape. So here is the green one. I'm going to use my milky green for the light color part of the line. And here, my favorite type of mixed media that I use are from my colored pencils with my gel pens, acrylic paints, and watercolors, and my any type of glitters that I have that I can put on top of it. Now, I normally don't add my, if I have to add extra glitters to it, I normally don't do that until after the whole picture is complete. Now for the middle, to make it the lime look wet, I'm going to use, now this is, I thought this was a color, but it's not. It's just a regular gel pen like that. Okay. But it's a glittery green. And I'm going to do the inside of it to make it look like this, where it looks wet. My favorite thing of way to do a picture is, I love watercolors, and especially my Caran d'Ache Neo Color 2s. I love those. I love to do what they call a wash. Put a layer of my Neo Color colors down as a very first base, and then I'll top it off with my colored pencils to really make that color pop. And just so you know, also, I picked up a little trick
from Elena, with Calling with Elena. Oh, that goes my ear again. Hold on, guys, my ear's ringing. Anyways, she has a video. You have to look through for the video. I'll see if I can find it, but I know I saw it on her page where she shows. People were asking her how she was able to watercolor her pictures to get them being so flat. Well, she showed how she ironed the picture. Not just straight iron on the picture. She had a couple of loose pieces of paper, blank piece of paper on top of it. She ironed it out real quick with setting on medium, and then she did the same thing on the back side and stuff. But of course, you might wait till your medium, your paint is all dry first. I let it sit overnight just to make sure it thoroughly dries. That's just me. Okay. Number three, what are your very favorite mediums? Mine would have to be it's actually a mix between my gel pens and my Caran d'Ache Neo colors. Next question, question four. What was your very first expensive medium you ever got? For me, was when, that I got myself was a, I treated myself to the Derwent ColorSoft colored pencils. I am a Derwent girl. I'm not big on Prismas, unless it's their markers. I'm just not a Prisma girl. For me, it was when I got my Derwent ColorSoft. I found a deal on them a couple years ago, and luckily I had the money at the time, or I still wouldn't have been able to grab them. But they were on sale, the full set, the 72 set, on Amazon for $40. Had I known then that how much I liked them, I would have grabbed two sets just to have another set on hand for when I needed replacements. But those are my absolute favorite colored pencils. I really like how they lay down. A lot of people don't like them. But with any medium, it doesn't matter what it is, it's a learning curve. You're just going to have to learn how to figure out what is comfortable with you. You know, just because one person says, oh, these are the best pencils, doesn't mean it's the best for you. You have to go with what you like and what just you feel comfortable with. That's like a lot of people think I'm crazy because I like crazy art. Those are just what I like myself, too. Not everybody's going to like the same thing you like. Number five. Okay. If you could spend one day with any coloring YouTuber, who would it be? Well, that is an easy one for me. It would be Elena with Coloring with Elena. Even though I can see what she's doing on camera, she is just amazing when it comes to art. I don't think there's any medium out there that girl cannot work wonders with. Elena, if there's one you can't work wonders with, please let me know. Because everything I see from you, you have got a magical touch with. You are, when it comes to your calling, I love what you do, girl. Let's see. I'm going to do these ones in the corners first, these little ones, just to get them out of the way. This next one, of course, I'm going to do as an orange. There's not much there. Just a second, guys. Are you guys going somewhere? Okay, that's fine. No problem. I just want to ask my family a question. Let's see, number six. Okay. Chibi or Fly? For me, hands down, Chibi. I love Fly, but I just love Chibi. And anybody that knows me knows I just adore Chibi. I think Chibi is so cute. Don't get me wrong, I love manga and I love anime. But Chibi is just so adorable. And to hear if my son could say something out loud about it, I said he probably said, it doesn't say Mom. I'm looking at him. He's not even looking at me. Am I right? You can talk out loud. They know that I've got a family. Oh, okay. I think he's in Nashville. Okay, here. Number seven. Dover, Teresa Goodrich, or Marty Noble. This one is a doozy for me, as I love both of their arts. Absolutely love them both. But if it had to come down to one, it would be Teresa Goodrich. Absolutely no hands, no holds barred, Teresa Goodrich. Which, by the way, I meant to put it, I will put it underneath this video too. There is, on Facebook, there is a Teresa Goodrich group. It's not mine, it's a friend of mine. And I will put that link under the video too, as Teresa Goodrich herself is in there, and she loves to mingle and talk to all her fans that love calling her pictures. So she's in there, and she's a sweetheart. I remember talking to her not too long ago. She told me that, because I kind of got a vibe from looking at some of the pictures that not only that she draws, but from her homeland. I asked her, I said, where you live and where you grew up on, does it have an influence on what you draw? And she said, yes. So what she's depicting is actually everything that she's grown up around and then around her village, everything. And I thought that was so neat to put in what you see from your eyes, from your point of view, all the beauty that's around you from her village. I have never been outside of the U.S. I would love to go outside of the U.S. There's some places over in U.K. I want to see. There's some places over in Scotland and Ireland I want to see. My husband's got family from Scotland and Ireland, mostly Ireland. And I've got family from Sweden that I was told about that I have never met. I'm still trying to find them. But I would think it would be so neat to get out of the United States when you can, not now. There's too much going on right now, but when you can. And just to let you know, for the inside of the rye or inside of this orange, I'm going to do this orange, glittery orange jelly roll. There's not many there at all. Now I'm going to come up here. I'm going to do the same color, actually, for this one, too. I've always wanted, I also have a dream of going to Australia. That's been one of my dreams. I want to go to Sydney. I also would love to go to, and I don't remember the name of that zoo. Steve Irwin's in his family's zoo. I can't remember where that, I want to go to that really bad. One of my dreams, and I know you could do it probably here in the States too, but one of my dreams I've always had, and I know they could be little parrots, but I've always had a dream of holding a koala. And also a sugar glider. I want a sugar glider so bad. I think they're just darling, even though they are high maintenance. Probably the same with koalas, but those have always been my dreams. I would love to own a sugar glider, but they are very high maintenance. Very, very, very. Okay, here, 8. If you could spend one day with any coloring book artist, who would it be? Mine would be Teresa Goodrich. Once again, Teresa Goodrich. Because I would love to just sit and see her draw. But hint, 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 Teresa, if you ever do videos, I think a lot of us would like to see you draw something. And just to see her village around her and hear her talk about it and, you know, and what she grew up with and, you know, fond memories, just stuff like that. But it would be Teresa Goodrich, hands down. Let's see here. Number 9. What is your very fave high-end medium to use? My very fave high-end media to use is my polychromos, even though a lot of people say that's not really high-end. It is to me, and also I like to use my neocolor too, my watercolors. Let's see here. I know you're only supposed to do 10, but I thought of a few more. 10, what do you have going on in the background while you color? Okay, for me, when I color, I normally have on my laptop, excuse me, my PC now. I have a coloring video on, you know, on low, or not even on low, I have it on mute, so I can watch it while I'm coloring, and 9 times out of 10, that video will be one of Coloring with Elena's videos. I love watching her color as I'm coloring along, too, and then also, since there's no sound going on and on my laptop, we have the big TV in the background going on. You know, now every once in a while I would get to put, if my family's asleep or so, I would get to put who I'm watching from my laptop or my PC onto the big screen. And 9 times out of 10, it's Elena, coloring with Elena on the big screen, and I'm coloring while watching her. Let's see here. Number 11. If you could spend one day with one colorist that isn't on YouTube, who would it be? Mine would be Osmet Moskovich, a.k.a. Ozzy. I absolutely love her. She is just fabulous when it comes to coloring. She took a mind of Elena. Ozzy, is there any medium you have not used that you can't master either? Your pictures are just like, wow. Holy cow. Every time you put a new picture up on Facebook, it's like you outdone yourself with the next one. I would give to have just a touch of the talent from you and from Elena and Renee, all these people that I see on YouTube that I happen to adore. I would give to see to have some of that talent. Number 12. Who, or excuse me, what are your most embarrassing coloring books to color? Okay, mine are my tattoo books. I have about 20, 25 different coloring books, and maybe two of them that aren't actually books, they're on PDF, is what I have. I have one of the ones, my first PDF tattoo coloring book was Jade Summer's very first tattoo book they ever had. The rest of theirs I've got in paperback. And then the next PDF one I've got of tattoos is the one by Coloring Book Cafe. Yeah, so. But I have a bunch of them, and I will tell you that a lot of the books have some of the same pictures in it because they buy like stock images and stuff. But that doesn't bother me none because I have in my mind, I have different ways I can color them, so it doesn't really bother me none. See, 13, question 13. Kirby Rosanne or Tim Jeff? For me, Kirby Rosanne. I look at Tim Jeff's stuff, even though it's pretty, but I'm like, my mind gets boggled. There is just no way I can even touch one of those. It's just not his stuff. I'm looking, I'm thinking, that is just too tedious. There's no way I could. This next one I'm gonna do is this one. My hubby and them went to the store just right around the corner here. I have no clue what they're getting. I think they were mainly going to the little post office they have in the store. They've got a little post office just right, which makes it handy for when we need to mail something out, which is right around the corner. Which I like that a lot. I like being near a post office, and plus, either that or you had to pick up some prescriptions, which our pharmacy is there too at the same store. Okay, now, this is going to be a lemon, and once again, I'm going in with my glittery gold gel pen for the middle. And we've got a helicopter going on above us. We've got a reserve unit here, Army Reserve unit here, so every once in a while you'll hear it. Not as bad as when I grew up in Leavenworth, which Leavenworth, Kansas is a military town complete. Just between all the prisons and the military there, in and out every month and whatever, you always hear helicopters there. Always, always, always. And I remember one time when I'd have to live in grade school. And I can't remember what prison it actually was. But we lived in a house that was, I'd have to say it was maybe 3 blocks from this just grassy knoll here or grassy field that we had that used to be like a where a school would go to play their soccer games and stuff, but it hadn't been used for a while. Well, we couldn't figure out 1 year how come all of a sudden it was getting mowed and looking meticulous and everything, and then all of a sudden it came on the news. That, and I can't remember which president it was, but the president flew into town to do a briefing at the military, Fort Leavenworth there, and we were like, no one knew that he was coming in until it had actually that, the helicopter in town, and it didn't say Air Force One or anything on it or whatever on it, just was a regular helicopter. But they had streets and everything around it blocked off, and even our street was blocked off. We could not get out of that, out of our house if we wanted to. The whole town was not really notified of what was going on, and I have to say, I was like in maybe fourth grade? I'm 47 now, that had to be about fourth grade, because I remember the school I was at, because the school that I was at the time was not too far from that field, but it was during the summertime, and I'm thinking, why is our streets blocked down? Because Leavenworth really didn't get blocked down from nothing. If they did, it was the fort that got locked down. It wasn't anything else. You know, but we couldn't figure out why is our street locked down? What's going on? And then we heard later on in the news what was going on. And of course, our newspaper there at the time, that is the Leavenworth Times, that I actually called the Laughing Worth Times. It's a daily newspaper. Because the reason I call it the Laughing Worth Times is that newspaper is notorious for never getting the news right. Never, ever, ever, ever got the news right. They always had to retract the story the following day because they never got their facts right, or they would misprint something, or so there was always a misprint, you know. And how they're still in business to this day, I really don't know, because they still do the same thing, you know. And I just, like, first time I started noticing, I'd have to say I was like 13, because I used to want to be a journalist when I was younger. I loved to write. And I remember reading some stuff, and I'm thinking, wait, this isn't correct, you know. And then the next following day, I'd read the paper again, and that same article that I read that the following day, that I said it wasn't correct, they were recorrecting themselves the following day on that very same article in my family's back. Guys, what did you get? Oh, you got some more of that. Okay, cool. Cool. Let's see here. Nothing. This one I'm gonna do as a line. I'm gonna do that. Powdered rim. It's okay that it's two different flavors. Sorry, guys. I forgot about that stuff, guys. Sorry about that, guys. I was talking to my family. We went to go get the rest of the makings for our dinner tonight. We're gonna have chicken Alfredo and garlic toast. That really sounds good. And now I'm going to take my dark green jelly roll with glitter in it. And I'm gonna do the inside here. These are the type of pictures that I like to use to zone out for. They just kind of help me zone out. Especially here lately. And I know a lot of people are feeling the same way, that they want something that they can zone out to. And I'm the type that, with, well, all that's going on in my bipolar and other crap that's going on in this world, that, you need stuff to kind of zone out to. Okay, now my 14th question. Kirby Roseanne or Alan Roberts? Now, this one is going to have to be Alan Roberts. I don't have any of his books, but I plan to. I really like Alan Roberts' horror themes, especially the one that's got poetry in it. I got a kick out of the first time I saw that. I was like, oh my Lord, I've got to have that book, because our son, even though he's going on 24 here in April, my son, since he was a baby, has always loved anything Toy Story, especially Buzz Lightyear. He is a Buzz Lightyear fanatic, so when I saw that page, I was like, I've got to have that book. Which, by the way, he does, I don't know if you guys know it or not, he does have, there is on Facebook an Alan Roberts group too, and I will link that down to below too. Yep, that's looking okay. Now, go ahead and come on out, Patrick, if you need to. Oh, okay. My last question: Selena Finnick or Tomolo Tomic? I hope I said that name right. Now, I like them both. The only thing of Tom's Love, Tomic, I have is there is a free PDF we gave out of just a few samples not too long ago. And also, I have some of Selena Finnick. I've got all three books of her, wait, four books, excuse me, of her Fadorables. I love those books, which if she's watching, I would really love it if you came out with a Fadorable for Christmas, or Valentine's, or Easter. Ooh, Easter, that would be cute. And I got her Dark Fiends, or Dark Fairies, excuse me, I got her Dark Fairies, I got her Unicorns and Dragons, and I've got her Fairy Tales. I do want to get some more of her, especially her Victorian ones. I never used to be into the Victorian stuff until I saw Conan with Elena do some of hers, and I thought, wow. There's a lot of things that I honestly didn't think I could color until I saw Elena's stuff, and I was like, man, you know, I've not been afraid to touch some of the things. That's like, what book was it that she was coloring in that I was like, I gotta have it now? Oh, Marty Noble's Goddesses. Well, I shouldn't say I gotta have it. I've gotta start coloring it. I had the book, but I was so afraid to really color in it. And once I saw her coloring in it, I was like, okay, I'm coloring in mine now. You know, so I was just like, holy cow. You know, Elena's stuff just on YouTube just blows me away. I was like, wow. I really like how this is turning out. I just wish that it showed the outer rim or the darker color so you could see how I do those two. But since I told you how to do it, it's pretty self-explanatory. Okay. 1:56 p.m. Wow, it feels like it should be later than that. We are having nice weather today. I don't know if it's what the temperature is, but it's going to be outside, guys. Is it cold? Cold? I mean, like, just a little? Okay. Oh, really? We're warmer than I anticipated. That's 50. We're warmer than I anticipated it to be. I have some more videos that I will be doing that I'm still working on my mystical fantasy, excuse me, mystical fashion pool. I've got one, the fourth part done. I just need to have the music added to it. And then I'm going to work some more on it. I'm doing it in 1 hour sections. And so it's easier for me to do that. Plus with our internet, which is AT&T. In our town, we only have two providers. It's either AT&T, which is who we've got, or Midco. And Midco, you get the runaround. Oh my God, the stories I have seen and heard from people, not only online, but talk to people here in this town about Midco. You can never talk to a person. They give you the runaround. And stuff. When we first moved here about 3 years ago, I tried for almost a week to get a hold of somebody up there, and I finally said, hell with it, I'm done. So we went to AT&T, and I think it was like 2 days later after I talked to them. The first time I tried to call them, was able to get through, and 2 days later someone was out to hook us up and stuff. But for this being a college town, it is, I don't want to say big, but for it being a college town, you would think we'd have more of an option. I'm going to come and do this one as mean too. I apologize, I got kind of quiet here. I just concentrated on this is why I don't do a lot of talking. If I mean, I'll do the ones that like this tag stuff, but for the most part anymore, I would rather do it where I'm coloring and have music in the background playing because I've gotten to where I focus now on what I'm doing. Because as you can see, when I was talking earlier, I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 things done. And normally I'd have half this page already done. Now on these, I try not to color over the lines because I want the black lines in between to show each segment. And this doing stuff like this is what helps me zone out too, one thing at a time like this. Have you guys gotten hooked on any new shows here lately? For me, I've got two new ones that, well, one of them's not really a new one. Well, it is, yet it isn't. There's a new show out that's got Mayim Bialik in it called Cat, Call Me Cat, or Cat, something like that. Well, it's based off a show from Britain called Miranda. And I love the one of Miranda the most. I love that show, and I've gotten hooked on that Miranda one. He cracks me up. And then the other thing I've gotten hooked on is WandaVision. I love that show. I normally am not one when it comes to anything based on Marvel or DC or that much, unless it's the old Harley Quinn that I love. But that WandaVision, I really like that. Haven't really been eating very much just because my stomach's been hurting like for the last 2 or 3 days. And it's just getting worse. And I've been taking medicine for a while, but it's just not tetanus. And I was calling my doctor today, but I know she's not even in today. So between Thursdays and Fridays is the day she's trying to take off. My doctor's stuff is not, it's about 30 minutes away from here, and I have not really wanted to travel that far. I've been trying to get my doctor's closer to home here, but since we're planning on moving, I don't want to get rid of her or a few other doctors since we're trying to move back to the area. I regret moving this kid to this town so much. College kids in this town just are much to be desired, and I know I was young once too, but I swear, I never did some of the things that they're doing up here, and plus, I knew if I did, if it would have been my parents paying for me to go to college, my mom and dad would have had my hives. They would have stopped payment everything on everything, and I would have had to figure out how to do everything on my own. So I knew, you know, even when I was in junior high and high school, my mom and dad had a look They didn't have to tell me no. They just had a look that said, "Okay, try it. See how far it gets you." Which is kind of like the look I give my son too. You know, I've never really had to. I've had to swaddle him or swat his butt a couple times when he was little on the diaper, just enough to get his attention. It was more like, "Oh, something touched my diaper. What was that?" But for the most part, my son's always told us, all Mom and Dad had to do was give me a look, and I knew not to even try them. I hope you guys are getting the gist of what I'm talking about when it comes to doing this. I will have to do a tutorial on how. People asked me a couple of years ago, and at the time I didn't have a video camera that would let me show or anything, on how I did my eyes. There is a couple books on my wall on YouTube, or not YouTube, excuse me. Well, actually I do. I have videos of them on YouTube. I've got two videos of two books of the same name, but two different artists, called Happy Hour. And they're about mixed drinks and stuff, and people ask me in those, how did you do the ice? Well, now that I've got a video camera, I could show how I did it. So I'll have to put that into motion too to show you guys how I did that. And I'm thinking about going ahead and cutting this short since you've got the gist of it. And I asked all my questions. If you've got any questions, just leave them down below underneath the video. And Stefan, once again, if you like my videos and any of the people that I've got links down below, make sure to click that red button, subscribe, and also click the bell for further notifications, and make sure to give us a thumbs up too. And with that, I think I'm going to close. Talk to you guys later. Bye bye.